For today, I'm going to start my next lecture, Unit 4, English-speaking countries. Unit 4, Lesson 1, read the dialogue and answer the question. As I have told in the previous lesson that our dialogue is a conversation between two or more people, you have to answer the question of reading this dialogue, which meal is Mr. Bucky going to have? Mrs. Bucky, I have made a pot of tea, Nadia. Would you like a cup? There are two characters in this dialogue, students. First one is Mrs. Bucky and the second one is the Nadia. Mrs. Bucky makes a pot of tea and she is offering to Nadia. Would you like a cup of tea? Nadia, yes please. Nadia accepts her offer. Mrs. B, how would you like it, pack or with milk or sugar? Nadia, with milk and sugar, please. Mrs. Bucky, would you like biscuits with it too? Nadia, yes please. What are you cooking? Mrs. Bucky, I am making your father's breakfast. Nadia, oh, when did he come back from Australia? Mrs. Bucky, he arrived home last night. He is still sleeping. He will go and make him up now. Students, look at exercise number 2. Tick the phrases for tea that you use at home. Tell the class what they mean. You have to tick the phrases that you use for tea. What do you use for tea at your home? If you use a cup of tea, then tick here. If you use a pot of tea, then tick in this box. And if you use a mug of tea, then tick in this box. Tea, milk or sugar, green tea or kettle. Packet of tea cozy or tea bags. Exercise number 3, listen to your teacher and complete the column about Ricardo's father, then complete the columns about yourself and your partner. Students, about Ricardo's father, you can check the column from page 106, take the help from page 106 and complete this column, and these two columns you have to solve it according to your choice. Students, open page number 21, unit 4, lesson 2. Many words have come into English from other languages including Urdu. Most of these are words that you already know. Match the words to their meanings. You have to match these words to their meanings. A bungalow, a house on one level. Chutney, a spicy sauce made from fruit or vegetables. Shampoo, a liquid that you use to wash your hair. Jungle, a thick forest in a hot, wet country. Khaki, a green, brown or yellow brown color. Punch, a drink made from 5 different fruit juices. Veranda, a platform at the side of a house with roof and floor but no walls. Pajamas, a loose jacket and trousers that you wear in bed. In exercise number 2, complete the text with the word from exercise number 1. Take the text from this word and insert in these blanks. One evening, Rudyard Kipling was studying in the jungle. He was sitting at a table on the veranda outside his bungalow, eating a dish of lamb curry and mango chutney and drinking a glass of punch. He was wearing old khaki trousers, sandals and a shirt. Copy and complete Sarah's letter to Sandra. Students, here you can take the words from exercise number 1 and complete this letter. Hello, it's evening and I'm sitting on the dash. V is already written. V means, you can write here, veranda. Wearing my dash, P is written, it's mean, you can write here, pajamas. And drinking a glass of dash, P is already written, you can write here, punch. There's nobody else outside, my sister has gone to dash her hair. S is already written, so you can write here, shampoo. My grandparents' dash is on the edge of a dash. My grandparents, B is written, Bangalore is end of a dash. J is written, it's mean, you can write here, jungle. So lots of wild animals walk around the house at night. In exercise number 4, plural nouns ending in OS and OES. Buffaloes, it ends on OES. Ecos, OES. Heroes, OES. Mangoes, OES. Photos, ends on OS. Pianos, ends on OS. Potatoes end on OES, radios ends on OS, tomatoes on OES, volcanoes on OES. Words that end in OS, examples photos, pianos and radios. Words that end in OES, buffaloes, ecos, heroes, mangoes, potatoes, tomatoes and volcanoes. Students, open your book at page number 22, unit 4, lesson 3, reading geography quiz. Read the question in the quiz and tick the answer you think are correct. Then check exercise number 2 for the correct answers. Which country has largest area and which has the smallest? Circle the largest country, underline the smallest. Australia is the largest country. There are three options: Australia, Pakistan and United Kingdom. Australia is largest and UK is the smallest. Which country has the largest population, number of people? Which has the smallest? Circle the country with the largest population, underline the country with the smallest population. Here are the three options: Australia, Pakistan and United Kingdom. Pakistan is the largest in population while Australia is the smallest. In 1900, which country had the most languages, Australia, Pakistan or United Kingdom? Australia. Which country has the highest mountain, Australia, Pakistan or United Kingdom? Pakistan. Which country has the largest desert? There are three options: Australia, Pakistan or United Kingdom? Australia. Which country has the longest river, Australia, Pakistan or United Kingdom? Pakistan. Which countries have dangerous animals, insects and snakes? Australia and Pakistan. In which country or countries would you find kangaroos? Kangaroos are only found in Australia. Sharks are found in Australia, Pakistan and United Kingdom. Koala bears are found in Australia and deer in Pakistan and United Kingdom. Open book at page number 23. Listen to your teacher and write the missing information in the quiz below. First one is, you will find a deer in Pakistan and the UK. You will find kangaroos and koala bears only in Australia. You will find sharks in dash countries, all these countries. Australia and Pakistan both have dangerous animals, insects and snakes. United Kingdom has no dangerous animals or insects, dash of the dangerous snake, only one of the dangerous snake. Pakistan has the largest population and dash has the smallest, Australia. Australia has the largest area, it is 10 times bigger than Pakistan and dash times bigger than the United Kingdom, 30 times. 2/3 of Australia is desert, this is equal to a desert 6 times the size of Pakistan. The Indus, which flows through Pakistan, is the longest river. It is dash kilometers long, 2500 kilometers long. K2 in Pakistan is the highest mountain. It is dash meters high, 8611 meters high. In 1900, the Aboriginal people of Australia spoke about 100 different languages. There were 8 main languages in Pakistan and only dash in the UK, only 3 in the UK. Assalamu alaikum class 4, we read about the pronouns. Pronoun is a word that is used at place of a noun. This is the definition of pronoun. A pronoun is a word that is used at place of noun. For example, Brad is swimming. We will use here he. He is swimming. Sheena is singing. She is singing. The examples of pronouns are is, am, are, I, we, they. The room is messy, it is messy. The word he, she and it are used in place of the nouns Brad, Sheena and the room. They are all examples of pronouns. Some other pronouns are the following: I, me, myself, you, yourself, yourselves, he, him, himself, she, her, herself, it, itself, ourselves, we, us, themselves, they, them. Let us understand. Copy the sentences in your notebook. Replace the underlined noun with a suitable pronoun. You may use the words given below. These are the pronouns: it, she, he, they, them. The mug fell from his hand and the mug broke. Here we will not use the mug two times. The mug fell from his hand and it broke. Gina dressed up quickly because Gina wanted to go to the party. Gina dressed up quickly because she wanted to go to the party. The teacher told the children that she wanted to meet the children in the hall for rehearsals. The teacher told the children that she wanted to meet them in the hall for rehearsals. The man was arrested because the man was caught stealing things from the shop. The man was arrested because he was caught stealing things from the shop. Copy the sentences in your notebook. Choose the correct pronoun. Roy wanted to do the cooking itself or himself? Himself. I hurt myself, himself when I fell from the stairs. I hurt myself. We will use myself for the noun I. This sum is easy. You can do it themselves, yourself. Because here is you, then it will be yourself. They want you to do the project by themselves or yourself. This is they here. Here will be themselves. She cleaned the whole house by himself, herself. Here is she. We will use her for the she. Change the nouns given in the brackets with suitable pronoun and copy the sentences in your notebook. Alicia and Nettie are very quiet. Alicia and Nettie are watching a cartoon film. Here we will put they. Harris gave a kite to his friend. The kite was green in color. Because the kite is a thing, we will use it here. It was green in color. This is mummy's watch. Daddy gave it as a present to mummy, to her. Gus and Roger will go to the market. They want to buy some return gift for the birthday party. Please give the children some money. They want to buy some snacks. Michael and Josh go out every evening. They play football. Harris needs to be taken to the hospital. He has cut his finger. Students, exercise number C is your task. Use the following pronouns in sentences of your own. Him, her, it, herself, ourselves, itself, us. Students, you can check the previous exercises and make the sentences. It's very easy task. Students, open your book at page number 18. Use suitable pronouns in the place of the underlined words. Copy the paragraph in your notebook. This is your task. Insert the pronouns in this exercise. Now for your creative writing, this is an application for sick leave. The principal, Light School, Ritke Campus, respected ma'am, it is stated with your respect that I am ill, so I can't come to school. Kindly grant me leave for 2 days. I shall be very thankful to you. Yours obediently, on the place of XYZ, write your name.